Hi, my name is Steven. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, please don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell so you get notified when next I upload a video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a LinkedIn bio page using the Divi theme. So if you already have a WordPress website, there's no need using tools like Taplink or Linktree to create an Instagram bio for your Instagram page. So this is what we're going to be creating today. You will be able to add pretty much anything that you want on your Instagram LinkedIn bio page. Because when you use tools like Taplink, for example, you have limitations of what you can do. But when you use Divi theme or Elementor, for example, you don't have any limitation. That means you can pretty much add anything that you want to add. You can add a contact form, you can add a video, you can add a call to action button. You can see here that we have a download button here as well. And we have all the social media icon here. You can see we have animations as well. So this is pretty much what you can do. And if you go over to the mobile version of this page, you can see that this is also responsive as well, because most people that will be viewing this page will be viewing this on the mobile phone. So you can see what the mobile version look like right here. So I'm going to show you how you can create this. If you use another page builder like Elementor or Breezy, I do have a video showing you how to do this with Elementor. I will leave that in the description box below. Or I will also put it somewhere on this video on the top right here. You can see it on the card. So let's go ahead and log into our WordPress website so I can show you how you can do this. Or you can go ahead and download this template that I already created for you, and then you can customize it to match your branding. So here you can see this is actually a WordPress website. I'm going to go back to the dashboard right here, and then we are going to go to pages, and then we are going to add a new page, and then I'm going to call this page LinkedIn bio. And then I'm going to click on publish template. And then over here under the page attribute, you want to make sure that you change this from default template to blank canvas. Because if you leave it on default template, that means it's going to show the header and footer, and we don't want to show the header and footer on the landing page. So make sure you change this to blank page over here and then click on update. And then we're going to go ahead and start creating this page with Divi Builder. And then from here, you can go ahead and start creating this page from scratch by adding columns and modules over here. But I don't want this video to be so long, so that's why I created this template for you. You can go ahead and download the template and import the template here. And then I'll show you how you can customize the template to match your branding. So to download the template, we're going to head over to this website called buymeacoffee.com/WP Lifestyle and click enter. And then it's going to bring you to this page right here. You can see all the templates that we have over here. If you click on extras here, you are going to see all the templates that we have. And this one right here is the one that we need, the Instagram link in bio. You can go ahead and download this template. If you click on it, it's going to pop up like this and ask you to download this. I won't be able to download it because I'm actually logged in. Let me go ahead and log out here. And now you can see that I've logged out. So if I click over here now, you can see that it will ask me to get this. If I click on this, over here you can go ahead and enter the amount that we are selling this, which is $10. I'm just joking, this is actually $0. We're not selling this. So you can put $0 here and put in your name and click on pay, and then you are going to download the zip file. So once you download the file, go ahead and unzip the file and take the JSON file inside, and then you come back over here on this page, and we are going to click on this three dots over here, and then we're going to click on this portability icon here, and then we're going to select import, and then you are going to drag that JSON file inside the zip folder and then upload it over here. So this is the JSON file. You can see that I just dropped it here. You can see IG LinkedIn bio template.json file. And then I'm going to select replace any existing content that we have on this page. And then I'm going to import that template. So now you can see that our template has finished importing. You can see right here how this thing was created. So you can see right here that this is an image over here. So I created this in Canva and then I saved it as a PNG file, and then I use it here. So you can create your own image like this if you want, or you can use any image that you want. It don't necessarily have to be in that form. Let's say I want to use this WP lifestyle icon right here. I can go ahead and click it, and then I can use it here instead. And then you can go over here on design, and then you can change the width and size of the icon like this. Also, keep in mind that more than 80% of people that will visit this page will be using their mobile phone. So whenever you are making an edit, make sure you click on this tablet icon right here and also adjust the size on the tablet as well. And then click on the mobile phone here and also adjust the size on the mobile phone, so that if I put this size here, for example, to 70, and then if I go back here to desktop, you can see that the size is on 30% here. If I put it on 70 on the desktop, it's going to look way too big. So go ahead and play around with it and put it to the size that work well for you. And then this one right here is a test module. You can go ahead and click on it and change the text in here to whatever you want, or if you don't need this at all over here, you can just delete it like this. And then this one right here is just a button module. You can see you can change the text over here, or you can just use this dynamic icon here to link it to another page on your website. And then over here you can put the button link. This is where you want the customer to go when they click on this button. And then if you go over here to design, you will have the option to design this the way you want. You can go over here to the button over here, and then you can change the size on the tablet. You can change the size on the mobile phone as well. And then if you scroll down here to the text color, you can change this text color to something else if you want. You can see that we have red over here now. And then here I do have global colors here. So these colors that I have here are global color. That means if you change any of this color, for example, is going to change. So let's say if I change this green right here to, maybe to a different color, it's going to change every single color that I have green on this page. So this is one way to just change the entire color on your page without going to do each and every one of them individually. And then this green color right here is just a box shadow. So if I go here and go down here to the box shadow over here and click on box shadow here, you can see that we have a box shadow here green. You can go ahead and change that to a different color if you want. And then here we have this section with a gradient background. So this is basically, you can see that we have two colors here. We have this color, and then we have a white color here. So if you go here and click on the row setting here and go to the background over here and then click on this gradient icon here, you can see how I have that gradient here. You can go ahead and change the color to something else if you want. So let's say if I change this color over here to yellow, for example, if I change this color over here to yellow, it's going to look like this. So you can go ahead and play around with this, or you can just change this to white or maybe black. So play around with it and change it to whatever you want. You can see that this video is like way too big because we are viewing this on the desktop. This is no problem because when you go to the mobile phone over here, you can see that I've already optimized the video to fit perfectly here, because most people will be viewing this page on their mobile phone. So when you are changing the colors, keep in mind that, for example, I change this color to black, you can see that this text right here is no longer readable. So we can go in here and change this text to maybe a different color so that we'll be able to read it when it's over this black background right here. Okay, so I've gone ahead and then I changed the background back to white, and then it looks like this. And then this one right here is just a video. You can just go ahead and delete that video if you don't need a video, and then replace it with something else, or delete this section entirely if you don't need that. And then we have all this button here, and then over here we have like a free download, so people can actually click here and download this ebook that we have here. You can see right here that this is an image, so I didn't really grade this here. I graded this on Canva, and then I downloaded the image and then I use it here. So you can see that this is an image. If you go here, you can see the image right here. And over here, we have the social media icons, and you can change this to whatever you want. If you click on the social media icon, and then you can click on each of them, you can click on the setting icon here, and then you are going to come in here and do the customization that you want. Resize the icon, change the colors, or you can come back over here and then you can add the link to your social media icon over here. And then background here is where you change the background color. You can see that I'm changing that Facebook background color over here. You can see like this. And then you are going to go ahead and click on exit video builder. So before you exit, make sure you click on save changes, and now you can see what your page will look like. And then if you go on the mobile, you are going to see that this is also responsive, and you can see that it looks really, really nice on the mobile phone as well. And then you can copy the link like this and copy the link, and then you can go to your Instagram page. This is my Instagram page for WP Lifestyle. So if you're not following, go over here and start following this page, because I'm going to start posting content here. that is not on YouTube. So if you want to see behind the scenes things that are not on YouTube, come and follow me here. I'm going to start posting here very soon. And then click on edit over here and then go here where you see website, and then you're going to paste that link like this and then click on submit. Now if we go back to the profile like this, now you can see that we have that link right here. If we click on the link, it's going to take you to this page on your website. And what this means is that when someone click on this, if you have Google Analytics on your website, that means you can see the traffic coming from your Instagram page. You can actually see how much traffic is coming from your Instagram page. This is a great way to track the amount of traffic that your Instagram is bringing to your website or to your landing page. So let me know what you think in the comment section below. And if you also want me to create another template using another page builder like Elementor or maybe Breezy, let me know in the comment section below as well. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, go ahead and do it right now before it's too late. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you get notified when next I upload a video like this. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.